Hello, everyone. Welcome to uTSP, putting you into the ITSP sphere. In this video, we'll be discussing an excellent way for you to manage your company's printers. This method is incredibly intuitive, and the best part of it is that it's free. Traditionally, some companies create a server or virtual server on-premise to handle all printing. In other cases, it is common to see domain controllers handle printing, as this machine acts as a central dispersion unit, controlling users, groups, policies, and login drive mapping, as well as printing. In a typical environment where printing is managed, there is usually a snap into the MMC called printmanagement.msc. This alone can handle most all of the entire company's printing needs, though it will almost always require an IT admin to intervene when installing the printer onto the user's machines. Through the following method, this will require less hands-on from you and your MSP team, leaving more time to focus on other business-related ventures. This method also releases your company's workers, allowing them to print from anywhere they are to the office. So let's get into it. First, head to the URL from the description on the server you wish to install this on. Click the Download It Now button. Select your OS and click the Download Now button. In this example, we're installing this on a Windows server. If you're installing this on a device other than a server, be sure you have administrative rights. You'll also want to make sure of the following: that this device is most likely a desktop, though a laptop would work. This device stays on during business hours or 24/7. This may require adjusting power and sleep settings. And that this device is wired directly into the network using an Ethernet cable. While it could be okay to use a Wi-Fi connection, there is always a chance that the device might become disconnected or that the signal could be interrupted. In such case, if this happened in the middle of a print, issues would occur. Once the program installs, you'll be greeted with a local account setup for the print server or main computer. Note the port your print service has been installed on. In this install, the port defaulted to port 9163. This means you can access this console three ways on this machine: localhost :9163, 127.0.0.1:9163, and the network IP of your device :9163, in this case 10.100.10.101:9163. Fill out all of the fields and then click to continue. Be sure to document your newly created password in your documentation software. Next, you'll be greeted with the print management console. As you can see here, there are two printers published. However, if you don't have any printers configured, you can simply add new printers to your environment through the Printers and Devices Control Panel section as you would on a client's device. Simply make sure your printers have sharing enabled. Here, two of my client's printers are configured: a Brother MSC9970 CDW in the conference room, and an HP LaserJet 300 M375NW at the main office. If you have printers that will not be available to your client or are PIN-protected devices, you can uncheck them from this list and they will not appear in the list when you configure printers for other users in your client's environment. While we're here, since we need to have our client's users be able to print remotely, we'll go ahead and configure this before moving to our user's computer. In this example, we're going to enable cloud printing. This will enable us to send prints from any device that you can see in this list remotely and off the network. So if you have field users on iPads that need to print to the home office over their 3G, 4G, or 5G connection, they can. Here, we'll be configuring this on a Windows machine. Click the green Enable Cloud Printing button. Then click the green Enable button. The app will then automatically configure the server or computer for cloud printing. While the server is configuring for cloud printing, we'll move over to the client computer to configure the machine for local network printing. Grab the link at the bottom of the page and go to your user's computer and paste the address in. click the green Download Mobility Print button to start the download. Go ahead and open the downloaded file. Plug in your administrative credentials if needed. During the install, you'll be prompted which printers you would like to add to the computer. This is handy when there are several printers in your environment. As you can see here, this computer hasn't been set up with either of the aforementioned printers. Selecting both of these printers to be installed, we'll watch and see how quickly these both populate into this user's machine. Directly after clicking the Next button, both printers begin immediately configuring for use on the computer. We'll send a test page to this printer to make sure that the printer is indeed connected. And here's the test print page and what you can expect yours to look similar to. Back on our server, the cloud print has completed. Click the Complete Setup button. The name of this will be arbitrary, so we'll name it after the MSP installing the software, uTSP. By default, the free edition does not allow you to select which printers you wish to share over the link. The free edition simply adds all of the printers available to the new machine, and then you will be able to remove the others manually. Click the Skip This Step button to continue. Click No Expiration for both options. This will allow you to document this particular link and use it across any number of your client's machines. Now, we'll generate the link. As you'll most likely be remotely accessing your client's users' computers, copying the link to the clipboard will allow you to paste your link directly to their machines using your RMM or remote management software. Place the link into your user's browser and download the new client. Open the file from the Downloads folder or the New File Download dropdown generated by your browser. As always, ensure you have administrative rights to the user's machine you're installing this to. Allow the installer to complete. In this example, we're running pings to the server to verify there is no connectivity between this computer and the server. Note, internet connectivity must be present while installing the software and connecting the machine. Click the Connect and Get My Printers button to establish connection to the server over the internet. You will see Fetching Your Printers Invite Link Received as the software prepares to download your new printers. As you can see here, after a few seconds, all of the available shared printers will be downloaded to this machine and automatically configured. Please remember that you will need to remove any printers not necessary for any users if you intend to continue using the free version of the software. If you happen to have issues with connecting remotely to the printer over the web, there could be a problem from the server side. Be sure all of your users are disconnected from files they may be using on the server, and then power cycle the machine remotely. Try re-adding the printers. This should fix any connectivity issues over the web. Here we're sending a test page to the printer remotely. If you pay close attention to the port name of the cloud printed test page, you'll notice this one mentions different information after the IP address and port of the server. IPP-based porting is used here versus a printer-based port used prior. Thanks for watching. Please click the like button if you found the information in the video useful. Subscribe to the channel for more MSP tips, tricks, and tutorials.